Okay, let's look at this example of converting using unit analysis. The goal is to convert 75 miles per hour to feet per second. We start with the given fact, 75 miles per hour, and we want to write it as a fraction, and we want to write our fractions with numerators and denominators. We want to write tops and bottoms, and so I'm going to write the 75, and I'm going to include units. Unit analysis is a process of letting our units decide what arithmetic to do. So we're going to put 75 miles, and then remember, per hour means 1 hour. For every 75 miles, we have 1 hour. That's the rate that we'll travel. Now, as we multiply and we want to convert this, all our conversions and all of our fractions that follow must be equivalent to 1. And all of our units lead us to tell us what to do. In this case, the miles is going to be my first goal. And as I look at miles, and my goal here is in feet, I want to think about a unit relationship that relates miles to feet. And I know that 5,280 feet is equal to 1 mile. And I'm going to write that fact in fraction form to convert. And I know which order to write it because my miles is on top. And remember, in fractions, units can cancel just like numbers, but they'll cancel when one is on the top and one is on the bottom. So since miles are on top in the previous part of the fraction, I want miles down here. So 1 mile is equal to 5,280 feet. Now I'm going to go on and show you that canceling and the unit elimination here, because we'll mark out the miles and the miles. We no longer are dealing with miles. Now we are dealing with feet. And the feet then match up to the unit that we're wanting. Next we have feet over hour. But we don't want hours, we want in seconds. So to convert to our seconds, we need to convert that hour unit. And again, because the hours are going to lead us, the hour is going to be on the top so that my hours cancel. And what fact we know about hours is that 1 hour is equivalent to 60 minutes. And we'll put that 60 minutes on the bottom. But again, we're not looking for minutes, we're looking for seconds. So we'll need one more conversion, and that conversion would be that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. And again, notice how the units are leading us with our facts. The facts we use are the facts that are commonly known or that will be given to us, and it is our units that then will let us know to cancel, what to cancel and how to cancel them. Hours, cancel hours. Minutes, cancel minutes. And we know we're in the right direction for our answers when we notice on the top we're left with feet, and on the bottom of our fraction we're left with second, and that is the unit that we needed our answer to be on. And then to simplify the problem, we'll just multiply all of our top numbers, 75 times 5,280, and that gives us 396,000. Over 60 times 60, which is 3,600. And when we do that division, we'll end up with the answer, which is 75 miles per hour is equivalent to 11 feet per second. And this is an example of how you can convert using unit analysis.